Christians eat food and...
I love Christmas. I wonder what it would actually be like to meet Jesus.
I was just thinking exactly the same thing.
Where are we, Al?
I've no idea, Justin. Jesus Christ! It's Jesus Christ!
Hi, guys!
Birthday, Jesus.
Oh, thank you. It's next Thursday, actually, but, what the hell? Look, what are you doing here?
Well, nothing really. We were just thinking, you know, how cool it would be to come and meet you and hang out with you a bit.
Nice one. Well, while you're here, are there any miracles I can do for you, or, you know?
Well, now you mention it, Jesus, I really want a new look for Christmas, and I was wondering if you could make me look a bit more... hunky?
Stand by.
Jesus, I'd like something a bit sexy too. I was thinking that maybe you could put my boobs up just a little bit.
Not a problem. Hang on.
Oh, yeah. Thanks, Jesus. You are brilliant.
Jesus, stop messing around with those clowns. It was enough for you to play with those lepers. Get back up here.
Oh, Dad! I hate you! I've got to go. I'll see you later. Alan, I'll see you next week.
What's your right read?
He's lovely, isn't he? I like him.
Eventually, you probably, you know, just end up... And then the family go home, gradually. And then me and Maureen will make love in front of the fire, and that'll be the end of it.
Making love in front of the fire, though, that's always a nice thing to do on Christmas Eve.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like that, yeah.
What's up with you?
Nothing, I just had the weirdest dream.
Really?
Yeah. I don't know.
Okay, coming up, I give one young lady a Christmas surprise she'll never forget. See you then. The Sunday Night Project. I'm Simon Pegg, and I'm very happy to be joined by Justin Lee Collins and Alan Carr.
Nice Star Wars intro there from the Kaisers.
That was great. It was the Imperial March from The Empire Strikes Back.
Now, Star Wars, is that your favourite film of all time?
I guess so. I mean, it's probably the most significant film to me. I love lots and lots of films, but Star Wars had a big impact on me, as it did a lot of kids, yourself included.
Absolutely. Yes. Do you remember where you were the first time you saw it?
ABC Cinema, St. Aldate Street, Gloucester, 1977.
Cannon Frogmore Street, 1977. 3 years of age with my gran. I cried when the lights went out.
Did it really have that big effect on your Star Wars?
Yes, it did.
Really?
Yeah, I'm still
it's the same as like Girls World had on you. Remember that sort of...
Oh! June 17, 1984. Outside Argos. My hair would be like that one day.
Simon, you were almost severely hurt on a film set this week, weren't you?
Yes, one poor woman thought she'd almost killed me.
The first scene in the can, the director has an important job for him.
Right, here's the setup.
I'm filming a festive TV commercial for a children's charity.
It's all being filmed at the O2 Arena's indoor ski slopes. I'm playing Santa, but I need someone to play my elf, and lucky Emma here has got the part. She's been set up by her flatmate, Daniel. What Emma doesn't know is the whole thing's a stitch-up. The director of the shoot is an actor, and with the help of a stuntman Santa, a runaway sleigh, and a destructible elf village, we're about to ruin Emma's Christmas.
Let's do it.
Emma arrives on set, and we start filming the first scene.
Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas!
Really, really good. Just jack it up a little bit.
Oh, like. What?
Yeah.
I love you, Santa. You save Christmas.
with the first scene in the can, the director has an important job for Emma.
Can you do one thing for me?
Yeah.
Can you just stay by the sleigh and I'll see you in about 10?
Cool.
Okay.
Cool.
That's pretty easy.
Time for me to put my fiendish plan into action. Step one, get Emma to leave the sleigh.
Could you do me a huge favour?
Yeah, of course I would.
Could you get me a book, some water?
Yeah, of course I would.
Get us 2 bars of chocolate, 2 bottles of water.
All right, honey, okay, tell him where I've gone, all right?
Thank you, Emma, I will.
Silly girl. With Emma away, it's time for step two. I swap with the stuntman.
Good luck.
It's fake Santa now, Phantom. The stuntman is in. And not a moment too soon, because Emma's on her way back, which means it's time for step three.
Here we go.
Release the brake.
Slayer?
Did I?
He just asked me to go and get chocolate.
Something I asked you. It's the one thing I asked you was to watch it. That's ruined Christmas as well.
Time to put Emma out of her misery.
Ho, ho, ho.
You've been stitched up by the Sunday Night Project.
I'm not good.
Oh my God, I'm on TV and I've just been fooled at once.
Look, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Simon? The girl who killed Father Christmas, Emma Bullivant, is here in the audience this evening. Emma, stand up for us, please, love.
You
killed Father Christmas. What am I going to tell my kids?
Do you know what? The whole time when the director was having a go at me, all I thought is, I'm sure they should have a runner to do this. I'm sure there should be a safety person. Why is he shouting at me?
Emma Bullivant, everybody. Merry Christmas, Emma.
Let's find out who knows the most about the guest host!
That's
me. Okay, here are the rules. Each team is playing for one side of the audience. Alan for the left. And Justin for the right. At the end of the quiz, the winning team will give £1,000 to their side of the audience.
Yes!
Before all that, though, let's meet the teams!
At Christmas, everyone should be with their family, and tonight is no exception. I'm with Simon's sister. It's Katie Penn!
Continuing the family theme, it's a woman who knows him better than anyone. It's his dear mum, Jill Pegg.
Okay, don't embarrass me. Let's begin. I have sectoral heterochromia. What is that?
Is it something you've made up just so you can park closer to Tesco?
You got me the sticker.
Is it being born on Valentine's Day?
No, it isn't. Ooh. Although that is my birthday. Well done, Katie.
Thank you.
Sounds like a...
Mrs. Peck, you must know.
Sounds like a Croatian lap dancer, doesn't it?
Do you think it's man boobs?
Man boobs?
My mom, everybody. What did I effing say?
Man. This is another thing we have in common. We both love Star Trek, we both love Star Wars.
We both have a small A cup, perhaps. No more guesses, because the answer is quite interesting. It means that my eyes are two-tone. They're mostly blue-grey, but in my right eye, I have a flash of brown.
the long name makes it sound impressive.
It does make it sound like
but
something
when you described it, it sounded really dull.
I know.
Blue grey with a flash of brown.
Okay. Here's a picture of me with Gillian Anderson, my co-star in How to Lose Friends and Alienate People. She wrote a message on the mirror in my dressing room when we did Letterman together, which says, Peg, I can't believe you're blank, 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 die scumbag. What are the missing words?
Peg, I can't believe you're not really a gynecologist.
I can't believe you're telling me this isn't butter. Die scumbag.
No, it was actually, and the answer is far less funnier than any of these suggestions.
Well, give us a clue, though. I want
to get it was
points.
Something to do with the fact that I couldn't come...
Is it a premiere?